think with Batista, you see this mountain of an individual, over 6 feet, 300 pounds plus, tattoos, shaved head. There's a whole lot more than meets the eye.
I've never admitted this to anyone, but for 6 years I've been watching you.
I had the perspective of he always had something to prove, like through all of his success, which is his Hall of Fame career. It always felt like he was giving off the energy that he always had something to prove.
I lash out, and when I lash out, people get hurt.
I've had a lot of matches with Batista, and I think all of them mean something, because anytime you get two performers that are at a level of success, both Batista and John Cena were loved by the audience. Very rarely was the perception of good guy versus good guy equals good event. It's always usually a disappointment. And then I kind of came in and shook everything up, where it was almost like the John Cena character will be good until we put him with another good guy, and then the audience can turn on him.
We're gonna find out who's better!
The answer's gonna be me.
But it made for a lot of tough nights with me, because even the nights that I did well, it was like I was playing on the road every night. I never had a home game.
There's an explosion brewing at the biggest blockbuster of the summer.
I was more than ready to test myself against Batista's power. But with someone like him, one wrong move is too many. One second I'm flying in the air, and the next I'm hearing his music playing, and he's announced the winner. I wanted that win really bad. I wanted to put my stamp on the whole who's better discussion between me and Batista. But now I knew the stakes, and any time we'd compete, I wouldn't mess up that same way again.
Yeah. Yeah.